Yesterday, an appeals court in the state of New York decided that Ivanka Trump cannot be a part of the ongoing lawsuit from New York Attorney General Letitia James. And it's because the statute of limitations on Ivanka has expired. Now, this is actually a very interesting decision from this appeals court, because they're not saying, nope, there's no evidence that Ivanka did anything wrong. They're just like, well, technically the statute of limitations expired, so you can't go after her. So in case you're wondering, the statute of limitations has not expired for Donald Trump and his two sons, Don Jr. and Eric. So how could it be that the statute of limitations for one kid with the company expired, but not the other kids and not Trump himself? I mean, Trump was president, so he wasn't supposed to be working on the company. Ivanka was in the White House, so she definitely wasn't working with the company. That's why her statute of limitations expired. So why is everybody else still involved? Well, the appeals court addressed that too, because the appeals court said, listen, the attorney general has kind of pointed out that everybody else was still allegedly committing crimes, or that the crimes they had previously committed were still ongoing. But because Ivanka wasn't there, her alleged criminal activity would have ended. So this ruling from the appeals court that basically does say Ivanka gets to get away with it also makes mention of the fact that they've already kind of proven to us that everybody else was still breaking the law. Now, it's annoying and it's frustrating that Ivanka Trump gets off the hook for this, but it is kind of telling that the appeals court was like, but everybody else, you're still there because we think, based on the evidence, you were still breaking the law. And of course, that would run all the way up to the year 2021, according to the lawsuit. That's how long they were lying, allegedly. Again, it's all alleged. Nobody's been convicted. They were allegedly lying to the regulators. They were lying to the tax authorities. They were lying to the banks. They were lying to the real estate investors. They were lying to everybody, according to this lawsuit. And Ivanka now doesn't have to worry about it. She doesn't have to worry about being barred from doing business in the state of New York, as the rest of her family now has to be concerned about. So everything's fine for her, but not for the rest of the family. Now, what could happen, and I don't think it will, but I gotta throw it out there because it is, of course, a possibility. Now that Ivanka understands that she cannot, will not be prosecuted for this due to the statute of limitations, she might be able to flip on her family. I don't think she will, because technically right now she has nothing to lose anymore. Like, she's not at risk of losing her freedom. But if she is free to, you know, speak about what happened, because she doesn't have to worry about getting prosecuted, she might become a little more loose-lipped with some of the secrets the family had with the business. Again, I don't think that'll happen, but I've got to mention it because it is a thing that could happen. But either way, Ivanka gets off scot-free. But the rest of the family, as the appellate court said, looks like they kept breaking the law, so the statute of limitations has not, in fact, expired for the rest of the Trump family. Thanks for watching, everyone, and, well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video, where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.